I'm Geryah Dingle, the K9 Scent Boss, and today's video is going to be a little different. Let's get into your question about commingling essential oils in scent detection training. It's generally recommended to avoid mixing essential oils together because they can interact with each other and alter their chemical composition, potentially affecting their scent profile. This can make it difficult for dogs to accurately detect and distinguish between different scents, which is obviously not ideal for training purposes. However, Mike asked about a technique he had seen on Facebook forums and from other scent detection trainers that involves commingling individually scented Q-tips in a scent vessel. He wanted to know why this method wouldn't lead to transference of oils between the Q-tips over time, potentially changing the odor profile and distorting the scent. It's a great question, and while I don't have a definitive answer, I can provide some insight based on my own experience and some research I've done. It's possible that some transference of oils could occur between the Q-tips over time, but the amount of transfer would likely be small and may not significantly affect the overall scent profile. That being said, it's important to note that the scent profile of a cocktail can change over time and with use. So it is generally recommended to create fresh cocktails for training sessions or store them separately to ensure consistency and accuracy. I also want to point you to some research being done by Laura, a professor of chemistry at Grand Valley State University. She and her colleagues are using gas chromatography, mass spectrometry, to identify the components of certain oils from numerous commercial suppliers, revealing a wide range of impurity levels. Let me break that process down real quick for us humanoids. Imagine you have a bunch of different toys in a big toy box. You want to find a specific toy, but you don't know what it looks like. So you decide to take out all the toys for your dog and put them in a line. Then you bring in a very special machine that can smell each toy and tell you exactly what it is. The machine is very much like a smart nose. It sniffs each toy and tells you what it smells like. That's kind of what gas chromatography mass spectrometry does. It takes a mixture of different chemicals and separates them out so you can see what each one is made of. It's like separating the toys in the toy box so you can see what each one is. Then it uses a special machine to smell each chemical and tell you exactly what it is made of. This helps scientists figure out what's in different things like food, water, perfume, or even our essential oils we use in canine scent work. This research is fascinating and highlights the importance of using high quality oils for scent detection training. Of course, there are many variables to consider, and every handler and dog team is different. What works for one may not work for another, and it's important to do your own research and experimentation to find what works best for you and your dog. I find it best to use a variety of essential oils to ensure the best success for your dog. But I hope this video has provided some helpful information and insight into the use of commingled Q-tips in scent detection training. And if you want to learn more about cocktailing hives, you can click or tap the screen right here or check the links in the description below for my full scent work playlist. Until next time, continue to get after it.